Hey guys, before we start the video, I just want to let you know that I have updated my intro. It is bigger, better, and longer, so this is the intro that will now play from now on in front of all my videos. So, just want to say that. So, cue the intro, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. Yo, what is going on, guys? It is the Ultimate Frozen Fan back here for another unboxing slash build show off video. Today I have the Lego Star Wars 20th anniversary Anakin Skywalker's Podracer from the Phantom Menace. Now, hardly anybody likes the Phantom Menace, that's a fact, but I think we still can all agree that Anakin Skywalker's Podracer is pretty awesome. At least I think so anyway. Now, because this is a 20th anniversary, apparently it includes a 1999 Luke Skywalker collectible minifigure, which is a re-released replica of the original ones from back in the day. So, each set includes a replica of an original LEGO Star Wars minifigure, display stand included with 5 to collect. So you can get Princess Leia, Lando Calrissian, Darth Vader, Han Solo. Now, I would love to get my boy Han Solo, but I don't think he's included in this pack. Like I said, I'm not sure if these are mystery, like it contains one of these 5 figures, or if each figure is exclusive to one set, you know what I mean? So we won't know until we open it up, so let's get to it and crack this thing open. Okay, let's dump everything out, shall we? Okay, so here we have the two noodle things that'll hold the pod racer things together. Oh, let's see how many. This has 279 pieces, so not too bad. Yeah, so here's the bags numbers. Bag number one, build that first. Bag number two. Build that second, bag number three, build last. And then we have some stickers here, okay, as always. And then we've got the really big instruction booklet. So yeah, this is going to be a fun build. Let's see if I can find that Luke Skywalker figure in one of these bags. There he is. You can see there's his flight suit and everything, so... that's definitely Luke Skywalker. Okay, so I'm not sure which set Han Solo is attached to, but I would love to know, because I would love to have my boy Han Solo, so. Yeah, so. Alrighty, well, I am going to go ahead and, trying to get this in frame here so you can see all the pieces and everything. So I am going to build this, and I will be right back when I have it done, so see you soon. So before I start building, guys, here's something kind of cool. In this instruction booklet, it says 20 years ago, a long time ago, in a design studio far, far away, we began reimagining iconic vehicles, characters, and scenes from the Star Wars universe as exciting new models and minifigures. To celebrate the 20th anniversary of the LEGO Star Wars franchise, we have selected some of our favorites from the last 20 years and brought them up to date with this new collector's edition to make it extra special. We have included each set with an exact replica of an original Star Wars minifigure. So, and then you can see there's a... so it shows, like, the... through the years, so like in 1999, this was the first version of the pod racer they showed, kind of blocky and whatnot, so. I guess it doesn't have regression, just 1999 to 2019. But they made many, many sets of Anakin's pod racer. They made mini ones, they made big ones, you know, etc. So, let's see what else. So this one does definitely come with Luke Skywalker. Okay. And, oh, here we go. Okay, so let's see. Han Solo comes with, God, I don't know what the heck that is. Okay, so Darth Vader comes with an AT-ST. Lando Calrissian with a snowspeeder, and Princess Leia with the Slave One. So I gotta find whatever set that is. Let's see what else is in this instruction booklet. Oh, some pictures from the first Star Wars. So then there's the Podracer in the movie. And the instructions, so yeah. Alright, now I'm going to start building it, and I'll show it off to you guys when I'm done. Okay, I'm back. And would you look at this thing, guys? I mean, look at the scale. I mean, friggin' the engines and everything. And, I mean, it's got to be built, you know, to minifigure scale. But this thing is huge. It's bigger than it looks like on the box. I mean, I was not expecting it to be this big. But I'm glad it is, because I love it. This is the... This looks like the one that we actually got to fly in LEGO Star Wars, the video game, as well as LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. If you didn't play any of the original ones, you don't know exactly what I'm talking about. But yeah, trust me, this Podracer looks just like that one. It's the Podracer that I always wanted. So take a look at the turbo engines, the electricity there. Look at the place where Anakin sits, the sides. If you notice, this thing uses a lot of Technic pieces, not just Lego bricks, so I always like when they mix Technic as well as regular Lego bricks. So for minifigures, you get, of course, Anakin Skywalker to pilot his thing, so I think we'll put him in there now so you can pilot it. Well, I'll do that off screen, but anyways, then we've got Padme Amidala. Also known as Princess Leia and Luke Skywalker's mother, slash Anakin's girlfriend. Okay, so you figure if in the movie, like, Anakin's, like, maybe 10, she's gotta be, what, like, maybe 16, 18? They're a pretty far gap apart, if you ask me, but, I'd say they're probably at least, like, 10 years apart. But, of course, by the second one, when Anakin grows up, you know, then the perfect age to, you know, start dating and get married and whatnot, but... I don't know, I just always found that interesting that Padme's a queen and probably like 16, 18, while Anakin's just a little tyke. So, anyway, so, yep, so, ladies and gentlemen, Luke Skywalker and Leia Skywalker's parents. Aren't they something? Yeah, so, and here is Luke Skywalker. Man, if you take a look at how far we've come with LEGO, I mean, his face is yellow, and he has just, like, the basic details of the black eyes with no shining pupil, and then just a mouth. Like, no details whatsoever, you know, they were real simple back in the day. And this is kind of how he looks in LEGO Star Wars as well, just he's skin-colored instead of yellow. But way back in 99, they were still making the LEGO figures yellow, even if they were human, so... Yeah, that is actually pretty dope. I'm digging that. That is a nice little recreation there. 20 years. Yeah. I have a feeling just these things are going to be going for big bucks on eBay. Not even the whole set. Just they'd be selling this little minifigure for probably $30. Probably something like that. I don't know. But anyway, so... Alright, so give me just a sec. Let me put Anakin in his pod. Okay, so that's about as good as we're gonna get him. He can't really hold these controls that well, but he can look like he's holding them, so... Also should note, I don't think you've seen his visor taken off, so... Yeah, you can see he's got little freckles and everything, and his little driving goggles. And a cool little feature that they added for this is that, they've got this really nice clear translucent stand, so that it just actually, like, stands up as, like, a display piece, so... But, And this is necessary in order to attach these things, because these are basically just attached by one little tiny string in the movie. You don't even have this. It's just two strings supporting these massive engines. Which, if you think about it, I always thought the engines should be better than the back. So I'd never seen that before, a ship with gigantic engines in the front. So that's pretty dang cool. So, but anyways, yeah, so if you flip it over, the... translucent pieces like connected there and holding the engines and everything, so just adds a little bit more weight, because in reality, if you just made this Lego thing being supported by these tiny little strings, they just fall right onto the ground. So very, very nice. I like how they implemented that. And then, like I said, this down here functions as a stand, so very, very cool. So let's give it a little fly test really quick. God, I just love this thing so much. The Millennium Falcon is my favorite ship in the Star Wars universe, especially the classic one. But if I had to pick a favorite ship in the new Star Wars, the prequel Star Wars universe, it would definitely have to be Anakin Skywalker's Podracer. This thing is really, really awesome. So I friggin' love it. So yeah, so, and I can't even imagine what it's like to drive one of these things. It's crazy. So, all right, guys, well, that is going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, be sure to drop a like. Let me know in the comments what you think of this set, if you'll be picking it up for yourself. Also, be sure to share this video with your friends, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any more videos. And until next time, guys, this is the Ultimate Frozen Fan signing off. Peace, and may the Force be with you.